Get yourself weighed again. You'll be in great shape.
All right, let's quit beating around the bush. Let's weigh the woman.
All right, hang on a second. No, we've got another one first.
Oh, okay.
All right. Hi, what's your name?
Jennifer.
Who are you here on behalf of? I mean, are you here as because you're a big Kings fan. Did somebody urge you to come?
No, I am, and my friend from work, Marjorie. So we win, we both go.
All right, fantastic. Go ahead, step right up.
What does your driver's license say you weigh?
No.
She's not going to tell us.
That's
funny. She's too bashful to tell us that, but she's going to step on a scale in front of TV cameras and...
Okay, thank you. Very nice. Thank you for being here. It's constantly surprising to me.
What do we got going there?
All right, TV guys, once again, don't show me. Don't show me.
All right. Really?
On the button.
I would have never guessed that she weighs that much. Honest to God.
What is your name, my dear?
Suzanne Baker.
Suzanne, you've been emailing us pictures of yourself all the week.
No, I only did it once.
Oh, that's true. It was one batch of pictures. And you're looking for a tall fellow, right?
Yeah, over 6'4", single.
You're looking for a big, tall man.
Yes.
All right, so come on down, fellas. Maybe you can get acquainted with Suzanne.
A tall man who likes a full-figured woman because you are a bigger woman.
Now, will you take the feller to the game if you hit it off? Or you got somebody in mind already?
No. No, I probably would.
Okay.
All right, well, step up on the scale. This is going to be something, ladies and gentlemen, because she has made a claim to us as to what she weighs, and it's going to be tough to beat, I think.
Well, it's not. It does not live up to her claim.
How close is it?
We've been misled, frankly.
Thanks a lot.
It's close enough. You've lost weight. Okay, you can step down. That's
how
fine.
How close is she to what she claims she weighed?
Can I see my driver's license?
Jack, yeah. What does your license say? That's not accurate. All right, camera guys. All right, you know the drill.
Okay, hold her. I can't see your hands.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah. Oh, my God, the first number is that? Whoa, whoa, whoa. You're a very attractive woman.
Beautiful, gorgeous.
Very attractive woman.
Looking for a tall fella.
People were just applauding your weight. I'm sure you appreciate that.
I'll drink to that number.
My God. So that is two big women.
I don't get your meaning.
We should have her. We might have to have her under. She might be smuggling another woman in her pants.
I'm impressed. I'm as close to speechless as I've been in recent days.
That's a tough number to beat.
She has set a standard. Listen to the buzz.
Oh, yeah,
listen to the buzz in this place.
There is a buzz in the building over there.
Oh, hey. All right. We've got a couple of lookalike contestants. It's about time. All right, come on over here. As if I have to say, what is your name, sir?
Scott Hendricks. But actually, I'd like to be called Hito Turkoglu today.
That's right, Hito. Hito. You know, you're kind of a Hito Pager Cross, but more like Hito.
You look like Hito, though. I mean, immediately knew who you thought you looked like.
Yeah, when I get out there on the court, you know, they call me Hito. So.
Sure, I'm sure they do.
Yeah, and you've got the post nose job Hito knows, which is good.
Exactly, I try to keep it current.
Say basketball happy me good.
All right, hang on a second.
That's what Hito generally says in an interview.
Hito, how do you feel about being in the Western Conference Finals?
Basketball happy me good.
extra points for the audio. And there's Hito. Wow, look at that. That's great. All right, Hito guy, go over there. All right.
No matter what you ask Hito, he says basketball
pretty,
happy me
pretty
good.
Impressive. All right, what is your name, sir?
David.
David, and you think you look like?
Vlade.
Vlade.
You're a half of Vlade shorter.
10 years old.
Vlade at age 10, okay.
Vlade at age 10, including the beard.
Yes.
You shave 3-4 times a day. Is that about right, Vlade?
That is correct.
How old are you, sir?
For real?
Yeah.
27.
Okay, you're an adult man. You want to date that woman over there?
No.
I think you two would make a good couple.
She wants 6'4 plus. I thought
you said 5'4.
No. Hang on.
My twin brother right here.
Scott the White Hoodie Downey Jr. lookalike contest.
It's not a producer for the Armstrong and Getty Show lookalike contest, but he would have won that.
All right, you know what would be very exciting is if our highly marginal Vlade lookalike were to be the official starter for the Smoke Like Vlade contest.
Yes, it would be exciting.
Which is coming up right after the break in about 5 minutes.
Are we all ready to go? How many contestants do we have who are willing to smoke?
Scott, come on over here, buddy.
Four smokers. One of which is a 19-year-old girl.
Yes.
This is going to be very exciting.
Who are the other three? Stretch, I know about.
We got hockey jersey guy right there behind you.
Oh, yeah, hockey jersey, Avalanche fan. And then this guy who doesn't smoke. As a non-smoker, sir, how do you rate your chances?
I think the fact that I don't smoke is going to be my advantage.
Really interesting.
Because your lungs are pink and tender. And
I know what I'm doing.
Right. Okay. I'm not sure that makes sense, but it'll be interesting to see.
Sure, it's a strategy. Nothing wrong with having a strategy.
I don't know with smoking if that would help or not. Probably not.
Man, yes. His lungs are all pink and fresh.
Smoking contest.
Oh, yeah. What's your name?
Jen.
Jen. You know, your voice is very feminine for a smoker. You smoke a lot?
Yeah.
Oh, you got to have this voice. You got to, hey, Armstrong and Getty, yeah, I love your show.
If you're not making me wet when I'm having a conversation with you, you're not that much of a smoker. Spitting stuff, loogies, lung butter, all kinds of stuff coming out.
Hey, show of hands. Show of hands. Who thought that was a really inappropriate sexual reference?
No, I meant, you know, your heavy smokers say it, don't spray it. You know that crowd. Well, hey, everybody, and the stuff's coming out, chunks of gray stuff.
Well, you could say that now, but I thought it was a weird female sexual reference.
No. Okay, the smoking contest when we come back. If you're a lookalike, come on down. We're doing that till 10 o'clock.
Ongoing. Plus, biggest Kings fan by weight female division.
I really think we ought to, maybe when we come back, we ought to announce where we are. And to see if there's anybody out there who's any bigger who thinks they might be able to come in and win.
I agree. Come on down to Bleachers on Expo Boulevard just to enjoy the donuts from Donut City. We've got coffee. We got beer, which I'm into, and it tastes great at 8:30. Valley Scale has got our official weighing scale. Sports Fever providing all the T-shirts and hats and jerseys. They're in your local mall, Sports Fever.
And in the 9 o'clock hour, we're having a hot dog eating contest, which I might enter. That's in the 9 o'clock hour. If you can eat a lot of hot dogs, come on down. That's for a jersey also, all right? So stay here. We're at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard. That's across from Cal Expo. You're listening to the Armstrong and Getty Show.
Break the Lakers off!
And now back to Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
Hi there, welcome back. It is 8:33. We are Armstrong and Getty, and we are live at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard. I have not had anything to drink.
You had a sip.
You know, isn't it?
That's all it takes for your brain to kick in.
No, I think it's being in a bar. I think just being in a bar makes me slur.
If you say so.
So we want you to come on down here. We're across from Cal Expo, and we've got plenty of room for you and stuff like that. And some people are drinking.
Donuts? Free donuts?
Actually, quite a few people are drinking for the time of day that is. I appreciate that. That's our listeners, I guess. we got more women to weigh. The lookalike contest is ongoing. We're about to start the smoking contest any minute.
The Smoke Like Vlade contest.
Which is going to be very exciting. All that's coming up. But right now, we've got the news with Cammie Lloyd.
Game 1 of Round 3 of the NBA Western Conference Finals takes place tomorrow afternoon. Tip-off 3:30 at Arco Arena. It is, of course, the Kings hosting the Lakers. And L.A. coach Phil Jackson says his team has more of a challenge against the Kings this year.
You know, they're much more poised than this year. I think they expected that from themselves now. They expect themselves to be where they are here. And I think that gives us a greater respect for them.
We know how Kings fans feel about the Lakers.
Beat LA!
Shaquille O'Neal says the Lakers are ready for the Kings.
You know, we know what's been said, and we know what we have to do. You know, we match up with this team pretty well. We have to go through them, they have to go through us, and they asked for us, and now they have us.
You know, that doesn't sound
so
like...
So, Shaq, how big is your ass?
You know, that doesn't sound like much rancor. I mean, I know everybody, especially I think the Sacramento media more than anybody, is trying to build up the hatred between everybody and the things Phil Jackson says. But every quote I've heard or read is fairly respectful. The most disrespectful thing I heard was Rick Adelman saying he wants to cut off the testicles of number 8.
Well, you have to have people that will cut his ass off.
Yeah. Oh, my God. It's you know what that is? It's harsh.
It's certainly a foul.
Well, fans are already lining up outside Arco Arena to get their hot little hands on a pair of Kings tickets. This guy and his friend spent the night out there.
We did everything last night. We even went for a little run, about a mile. Played a little Yahtzee, played a little dice.
Once again, game one tomorrow, 3:30 at Arco. Just want to let you know, in America's War on Terrorism, President Bush says if he had known what the September 11th terrorists were going to do, he would have done everything in his power to protect the American people.
Well, no kidding. Anybody who thinks differently is such a conspiracy nut. They should just sleep during the days and listen to Art Bell at night.
Speaking at a White House ceremony today, Bush delivered his first public response to the disclosures that the White House had received reports of possible terrorist activities, including hijackings, in advance of September 11th. And First Lady Laura Bush says Democrats should be working with the president, not criticizing him. On her European trip, the First Lady's defending her husband from that criticism that he didn't do enough after getting a pre-September 11th terror warning. She calls the criticism sad.
Who said that?
That is Laura Bush.
Okay. Well, she's right, but obviously she's going to support her president.
By the way, Cammie, some really exciting developments here on the contest front. We'll get to that right after the news.
Oh, fabulous. And Bakersfield police have arrested a couple who left their two-year-old son alone while they went to see a midnight showing of the new Star Wars movie.
Oh, good God.
Cops say the boy's 21-year-old mother and 24-year-old dad told them they had tickets for the movie, left the baby alone because they couldn't find a sitter.
People that stupid, and I mean this. I know I was called a bleeding heart liberal yesterday by somebody. They need to be put in jail forever.
Well, they need to have their kid taken away.
Well, obviously, because they're so stupid.
Yeah, spectacular. Live like animals.
Taking a look at your weather right now, it's 65 degrees. Looks like we'll be in the 80s today, 70s for the weekend. And for Jamie Coffee, I'm Cammie Lloyd for the Armstrong and Getty Show.
Yeah, I like that. Hi there, it is 8:37, Armstrong and Getty. We are at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard across from Cal Expo. Do we want people to scream, beat L.A., or is that just lame?
It's kind of lame. It's lame-ish.
Where's our cowbell? Scott, beat our cowbell. We need some,
The hell good are you? Yeah! Yeah! Cut off Kobe's balls! Yeah!
We have... All right, the
that's enough.
The fun went out of that quite quickly. That cannot end soon enough.
Let's chant New Turk Kobe, in honor of Rick Adelman's bizarre vow.
Exciting developments. We've got a couple more women to weigh in the biggest Kings fin by weight for Kings tickets.
Yes, we do. Some impressive entrance. Also, Mark, where'd you go? I believe our runner-up for the biggest Kings fan by weight last year, male division, has entered the stadium dog-eating contest.
Oh, well, I'm not entering then.
No, come on. Again, it's not about body shape.
But he weighs 500 pounds.
It's about what's in your heart. So it's resolve.
I know it's in his heart. Bacon.
All right, listen. It's time for the Smoke Like Vlade contest. We're going to have the weigh-ins in just a couple of minutes, but we can't put our smokers off anymore. So let's go outside for the Smoke Like Vlade contest.
Very excited about this. Whoever can smoke an entire pack of cigarettes the fastest wins. I think Vlade does it. Vlade should smoke during free throws. I think that would be really cool. If he had a cigarette dangling out of his mouth during free throws.
With apologies to the American Cancer Society, smoking looks cool.
That would be
rad. It just does.
Can you imagine him dribbling the ball there at the free throw line with a cigarette dangling out of his mouth? That'd be so freaking cool.
All right.
Included in our list of contestants is a 19-year-old girl who claims she can really bring it when it comes to smoking.
All right, listen, I need to examine a cigarette, please. Would you give me a cigarette, somebody?
Thanks.
Cancer stick, tar bar.
I'm touching the part he's about to put in his mouth. Okay.
Anybody smoking full-leaded cigarettes, or are you all smoking lights?
They're all lights. Everybody lights. We've got to figure out what constitutes a smoked cigarette, because...
Down to the line.
Down to the filter.
Down to the filter, man. 20
you
cigarettes.
Have to actually singe the filter?
20 cigarettes down to the filter.
All right. I tell you what, it's got to be really, really close to the filter. If it's not, we'll penalize you. Sir, I want you to know my hands are scrupulously clean.
I don't know. I don't have the slightest idea if this contest is going to take an hour or 2 minutes. I don't have any idea because I don't smoke. How long do you have any prediction? Because we can't watch you smoke for 45 minutes.
All right, Avalanche guy, what's your name? How long do you think it'll take you?
Probably 20 minutes.
20 minutes, okay.
And what's your name?
John.
All right, John.
See, if that's the case, we're going to have to get him started and then go weigh some people.
I don't think it's the case. I really don't. What's your name? How long is it going to take you?
Richard Dobson. I say it'll take me about at least 12 minutes.
I just think it's 12 minutes, Richard. How about you, my dear?
Well, we have to smoke one cigarette at a time. So if we do that, it's going to take longer than 20 minutes.
What's your name?
Jen.
All right, Jen, we're going to figure that out. All right, and your name once again?
Jackie.
And how long do you think it's going to take you, Jackie?
I have no idea.
She's 19. She knows nothing.
All right.
She's 19. Wow, mocking her for...
And you, buddy.
I thought I could smoke them all at once. I just learned that I have to smoke them individually.
No, I don't understand.
No, we haven't decided that.
No. We make the final rules, and it doesn't make any sense to me. You can smoke however you want to smoke. I mean, you got to use your mouth. I don't want you smoking out your ass or something.
I do. yeah, I would say burn them down however you can.
Yeah, I mean, smoke. Smoke like crazy.
Okay, here we go. Listen, there's no reason to wait any longer. Where's our Vlade lookalike? Where'd the Vlade lookalike go? He was going to be our official starter.
It's got to be, somebody's got to say, on your mark, get set, get cancer. Somebody's got to say that.
I'm really disappointed. Smoke them. No, listen. Smoke them any way you can.
With your mouth. With your mouth.
What are you getting in this for? Easy.
With your mouth.
Smoke them any way you want.
With your mouth.
Any orifice you choose. Just burn them down. All right, our Vlade lookalike is gone. That's disappointing.
Let's start it.
All right, on your marks. What? No,
however you
want
to smoke.
Smoke as many as you want, any way you want, with a body opening.
But I'm not, I would like to say this, I'm not sure that smoking more than one at a time is an advantage. I mean, I'm not sure that it is. But, you know, do it however you want.
It can't hurt.
Are you ready?
Yeah, okay. On your marks, get set, smoke. I hope everybody checked their letter. You ring the cowbell. That's nice.
Oh, God. Look at that guy in the hockey jersey.
Hockey jersey is going after
it. My God. Oh, somebody's going to yak. This is going to be very exciting.
Stretch is smoking like a champion, though. He's not even using his hands. Hands, he says. Hands. Who needs hands? I got lips of steel.
I guarantee you somebody's going to vomit. Guarantee it.
All right, our female contestant. Oh, Jen is doing several at once. 19-year-old Jackie looks so smooth.
Hey, I'm afraid we're going to end up with Ladder Company 5 over here.
All right, our non-smoking dude with a couple lights. I love the visual. Hey, they're lit, dude. You're all right, man. Don't need to relight them. We're going for an entire pack of cigarettes.
This might be our funniest contest ever.
Our smoke like bloody contest. Oh, my God. This is wrong on so many levels.
Now, is everybody smoking more than one? No, we've got two contestants that are smoking one at a time. The other three are trying to smoke multiple cigarettes at once.
All right, now we need station personnel to make sure. Listen, do not throw your cigarettes in the water anymore. I don't care what the fire hazard is. I know it's fire season. You have to drop it so we can make sure you're smoking them down, because we won't be able to figure out whose half-smoked cig that is.
Jeez,
go ahead. That's fine. That's plenty close. No, don't. All right, yeah, okay. Show them, then throw them, all right? Ryan, you're in charge of making sure.
Hey, I'm dying up here in the smoke. Was that just saliva, or did you vomit? Was that just spit? Okay, just spit. I thought she vomited.
Spit.
God, I got to move because all the smoke's blowing in my face.
How you feeling there, Jackie?
Fine.
Feeling fine, eh? This is a big moment. You going to call your mom and dad and tell them about this? Fantastic.
This is a very classy contest. This is the sort of thing that the radio salespeople like, because it gives you a good a qualitative in terms of listenership.
Right, exactly.
The kind of people that drive Lexuses and buy diamonds and Rolex watches.
Sure.
Like
we're
smoking
stockbrokers advertising now and all sorts of furs.
Yeah. God.
All right, how you doing there, Avalanche guy?
It hurts.
It hurts. Where does it hurt the worst?
Lips.
No. The lips hurt. Ouch.
Does anybody feel a lump forming in their breast? I mean, like in their chest area?
You know, I think I saw some cells change while I was talking to him. Ouch.
Oh. The American Cancer Society was very unhappy with us for this contest. They said they thought we were glorifying smoking somehow by offering prizes to people who smoke a lot.
I don't get it. I don't understand the rationale.
Jeez.
Hey, if you're driving around, come on down and emphasize us.
Oh, jeez.
We'll be here until 10 o'clock.
Oh, God.
God, how long is this going to take? He's about halfway through. Oh, look at him. Look at Stretch. Look at him. 5-1. My God, he's setting the standard.
He was lighting his cigarettes with the Jerry Lewis long flame method. That's always been so entertaining.
Oh, golly. How close are we? Smoke like Vlade, everybody. He's an NBA star. He runs up and down. Well, he lumbers up and down the floor. He seems to be doing okay.
The prize for this is a free chemo treatment. No, the prize is a Weber jersey, I believe. The one I'm wearing.
How can you stand it up there? Come on down from there. My God, there's a catwalk, some stairs right above the smoking stage, and the volume, the thickness of smoke is spectacular. Oh, my God, now I'm downwind.
It's unbelievable.
All right, ladies and gentlemen of the audience, who do you like? Who's going to win the contest?
I think the tall guy, yeah.
Stretch?
Old school, dude.
Yeah, right, stretch.
Kicking in old school, yeah. What do you think, buddy?
Oh, yeah, the guy with the hat, for sure.
Hey, are you here for the Mike Baby look-alike deal? Because you look enough like him, you might as well enter.
Oh, yeah? All right, I'm in.
Do you think he looks a little like Baby? Hey, hold your mouth open like you're breathing through your mouth.
Now that's not nice.
There you go. That Mike Baby, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Hey, who do you like in this contest? Who do you think's going to win?
Hey, you know, I liked number 19 for a while, but I think I just saw him yakking over here.
Did you yak? You all right? How you doing, man?
You okay?
Guy with a cat.
No, he's not. Did he yak? Establish whether he yak.
And it was just spit.
Who do you like in the contest, ma'am?
I like the guy with the hat, because, you know, when he lights those five cigarettes, it looks like he's going to catch the hat on fire. It's kind of...
Yeah. Hey, if hat doesn't win, there's going to be a lot of disappointed fans here.
Hey, let me talk to sales manager Jeff Holden, see if he's happy with our contest. You happy with the qualitative we're going to get out of this contest?
You know, if we could just get cigarette advertisers back on the air, we'd be in great shape.
Yeah, no. Are there still laws against that?
Yeah, we got a lobby for that, huh? Those are the good old days when you could advertise cigarettes.
Folks at Marlboro, if you're listening, give us a call. We'll give you a rate.
How close is Stretch? He's got five cigarettes left? No, he's got a whole handful. No.
No, he's just got half a dozen left, plus the ones he's smoking. Oh, Jen, you're doing good. Wow, Jen, come on. Find it somewhere within you. Her hands are shaking a little bit, but she's doing fine.
You know, it's a slight bit early, but I think we ought to take a break to make sure we catch the end of it when we come back. Because there's no way they're going to finish in the next 4 minutes.
No, look at Stretch. Oh, he's got some in his back. Yeah. All right, yeah, go to break right now.
Yeah, we'll come back and we'll catch the end of our smoking contest. I think they're going to do a pack in like 15 minutes, though.
And Michael Monitor, we might have to come back early.
This is very exciting. Armstrong and Getty, we're at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard. Across from Cal Expo. Stop by and see us. You're listening to the Armstrong and Getty Show.
And now back to Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
8 minutes and 20 seconds. How do you feel, buddy?
A little lightheaded.
What was that liquid that came out of you toward the end?
A whole chunk load of saliva?
No, no, no. That liquid that came out of you was bright yellow, my friend.
For a while. You know, I kept on shoving more tar.
Saliva is not yellow. Bile is yellow. Parts of your lung might be yellow. But spit is not yellow.
That little actually went into the lung. I really did.
Look at Jackie. She's still smoking.
She's just...
What the hell? What are you doing?
I didn't get to inhale.
She's just relaxing.
Oh, she didn't get to inhale him, so now she's actually got to, Calmer Jones.
Celebration.
So what was the final time for 20 cigarettes, an entire pack?
8:20.
That's stunning. From a guy who doesn't smoke, that's not possible.
Well done, sir. Well done. Anybody you want to say hello to as our champion?
The Cancer Association. God bless you.
Good God.
Yeah, we really ought to make a donation.
Your poor little pink lungs.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Now, listen to this. Listen to this. I don't mean to embarrass you, but I just found out, where do you work? Where do you work, Stretch?
I work at a cigarette store.
A cigarette store. Bested by Pink Lung over there.
Yes, I am.
Are you going to be able to go into work? They're going to make fun of you.
No, they won't, actually. I think they'll be proud of me for actually getting up here and doing this.
All right. Well, hey, this has nothing to do with the interviews I've just done, but a breath mint for all our contestants.
Yes,
late.
Yes.
Maybe seven or eight.
Hey, a hockey jersey guy, how you feeling?
My tongue is very numb.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Man, you look a little green, I got to tell you. You were spitting up some weird-looking fluid also.
Jen, what do you think? You all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
You didn't. You only smoked like 15 cigarettes in 8 minutes. That's a little embarrassing, frankly. But you're enjoying two right now.
Yeah, I want to inhale them and get the full effect from the cigarette.
God, the real smokers are sitting around just enjoying a cigarette after a cigarette smoking contest.
Hey, we've got weighings to do. Let's do them before the top of the hour. Let's hustle in and do our weighings.
We have giant women to weigh, ladies and gentlemen. Giant women in the biggest Kings fan by weight contest that need to be weighed. We are going to announce before we go to break what the current winning weight is.
Yeah, come on in.
So that we'll have an hour. power for you to contact any really giant friends you have. Oh, wow, look at the hand. Look at the hand that the champion of the cigarette smoking contest is getting. People love bad habits.
You know, I think it's really disgusting that, you know, we put a bad habit on display like that. And which reminds me, I haven't had a sip of beer in like 10 minutes.
Unbelievable. You have a question, ma'am. Yes. Oh, we got a guy with the Lakers hat in the building. We've got a guy in the building with the Lakers hat.
Break the Lakers off!
Things have turned ugly.
Hey, listen, before you start to fight him, I think he's a blind guy, all right?
He's not so blind. He just had sunglasses on. I think he's a blind guy.
No, I'm not. Okay. I was just trying to save your ass, buddy. All right. Hey, Mark.
Oh, man.
It's Mark, right?
Yes, it's Mark. Hey, great, big Mark.
It's our runner-up in the biggest Kings fan by weight division last year. Mark, you here for the hot dog eating contest?
Yeah, I didn't enter last year. I felt it would be unfair for me to win two in a row, and then, you know, we had the big showdown on the biggest Kings fan, but I'm here this time. I'm going to enter the eating contest.
All right, fantastic. That's next hour. We need to move quickly.
We've only got about 3 minutes. We got to weigh a couple of more women, and then when we come back next hour, we got all kinds of contests we've got to get to.
Scotty boy, who do we have? Who we have some weigh-ins here. Who's in charge of that?
One over there to your left.
Oh, there. All right. Oh.
All right, come on over.
All right, we may have a new leader. It's possible.
What is your name, my dear?
Samantha, Mark's wife.
Oh, terrific. Are you two going to go together if you get the tickets?
No, I'm going to take my dad.
Oh, that's great.
You know,
your old pa listening right now?
No, but he watches every Kings game sometimes.
Oh, great.
I hope for her sake she's big enough. I really do.
You know, I hope when, you know, my daughter's all grown up, we're still doing things together. It kind of warms the heart, doesn't
it? Do you hope she wins a heaviest woman contest
and
takes you to a ball game? That's what you hope?
I hope that happens. All right. Very nice. Very impressive.
Joe's going to show us the fingers here in the bar.
Camera guys, don't show me on this, okay?
The number is, starts with a, okay, I knew it'd start with that. Wow.
Woo. Pretty impressive.
Yeah, pretty damn impressive. You're up there.
All right. Come on over. Our, one of our younger contestants, hi.
Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
Jennifer.
How old are you?
23.
How tall are you?
6'2".
Height. Wow. It's all about height.
Yeah, she could be the new champion.
All right, come on. Sorry, camera, John. All right, go ahead. Step right up. You know, pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. Go ahead, step down. Very impressive. I'm not sure it's going to win, though.
Oh, yeah. See, the first number's got to start with a... Oh. You know? I don't know how many times people have told you this, but you're just too thin. You're just too thin.
For our standards, yeah.
For our standards.
Have you ever smoked a tremendous number of cigarettes at once? Because we can do that again if you want.
I think we should announce before we go to break here.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, okay. So that's her weight on her driver's license is actually closer than mine was when I was at my heaviest.
Congratulations for being honest on your driver's license.
Absolutely.
I think since you know the number, we should announce what the current number is so we've got an hour. If you know anybody in the Sacramento area that you could get here somehow in the back of a flatbed truck or roll or whatever to win the contest.
Who's got the official number? What's that? Okay. We'll talk about that. What's the official number, Scott? Is that right? You're pretty confident? All right, our number going into the final hour of the biggest Kings fan by weight is 423.
423 is the weight to beat. Is there anybody in the Sacramento area heavier, a woman heavier than 423? You could go to the ball game tomorrow. These are $500 worth of tickets. All right? You got a neighbor, you got a friend, you got a mom, you got a sister, whatever, that's more than 423. You think she weighs that much? Get her down here.
It's roughly $1 a pound.
To Bleachers. Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard for the Armstrong and Getty Show.
Talk 650 KSTE. Clear Channel Radio. The Talk Stick.
And now, live from the Talk 650 studios, here's Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
The winner of that gets a Pacers jersey, and that is from Sports Fever. Now, the most exciting development in recent moments is we have a woman in the building who claims she can beat 423 in the biggest Kings fan by weight contest.
I was not informed.
Women's division. We have a woman that claims she can beat 423.
Ooh.
So we'll weigh her when we come back. If you think you're in that range, come on down. We're talking, it costs us nearly $500 to buy these tickets. So,
oh yeah, this is a hell of a prize.
Yeah,
spectacular.
All right, well, more weighing and eating and that sort of the thing coming back. People are drinking down here.
Oh,
too.
You know what we haven't done yet. I'm sorry, we haven't done our Maloof sound-alike contest yet. So we'll do that this hour. All right.
Anybody who can sound like a Maloof, come on down.
Maloof sound-alike contest as well.
Perhaps hit yourself in the head with a hammer. That might help you. All right, here at the news, Cammy Lloyd.
Cammy?
Are you there, Cammy?
I'm here. Oh. There we go. I was waiting for my music to come up. The excitement's building in Sacramento for game one of round three of the NBA Western Conference playoffs. Tickets for the game go on sale at 10 this morning. Of course, it's the Kings versus the Lakers. Lakers coach Phil Jackson says beating Sacramento could be a little tougher this year.
I think we've got a terrific challenge out there in the world. I can't imagine us being able to win two games up there in Sacramento like we did last year in San Antonio. So I just want to go up there and do what we have to do, and let's get home court advantage back.
Now, the Kings cowbells have been criticized by many teams, including the Lakers, and Shaquille O'Neal wants Laker fans to trump those cowbells.
I'm telling everybody right now, bring what you want to bring, except weapons. Chris Stevenson, bring instruments, bring pots and pans, and bring symbols. Bring what you want to bring, and tell them Shaq so we can bring it. No weapons, please.
Game one tips off tomorrow at Arco, 3:30 p.m. Tickets go on sale in 1 hour out at Arco. They'll draw a lottery number to determine who will be first in line in about a half hour.
Or you can be just a really, really giant woman and come down here and get tickets.
Absolutely, Jack.
You know?
You guys think I could make it?
Biggest Kings fan by weight.
Yeah.
No, God, Cammy, you need you and like your mom, dad, a sister, brother to get on the scale to win.
Oh,
and like the doctor's office, we need you to strip down before you weigh.
That's your call.
Oh, and of course, we don't actually have tickets. We just have the cash equivalent of tickets, and we know somebody who would sell them to you.
Oh, okay, that's good. Well, if you haven't heard yet, L.A. Mayor James Hahn and Sacramento Mayor Heather Fargo have made a friendly bet over the
series.
Listen
to this story. This is the stupidest story I've ever heard.
Hahn is offering to send Fargo 34 King Tacos if the Kings prevail over two-time defending NBA champs, the Lakers. Fargo accepted, and she's promised to send L.A. specially bottled Sacramento water if the Lakers win.
Oh, God.
I don't even get that. Is it because they don't have any water down in Southern California? I mean, it's kind of a high concept political bet.
On the other hand, what are you going to send from SAC of tomatoes? Tomatoes or what?
It's very disturbing. Legislation, and they could send us smog.
How about the head of a lobbyist on a pike?
Be all right.
Well, the boss, he's saying get someone else to run for Senate. Political consultant Doug Friedline has hoped to recruit Bruce Springsteen to run as an independent for U.S. Senator New Jersey. Springsteen says he's not interested. Taking a look at weather, it's going to be in the 80s today, 70s for the weekend. Right now, 67 degrees at 9:07. In for Jamie Coffey, I'm Cammy Lloyd for the Armstrong and Getty Show.
All right, let's hear a little enthusiasm out of this crowd. Huh? Hey, okay, woo! Beat the Lakers, woo! Woo! Oh, my God.
Hey,
I just got a glimpse of the woman who thinks she can beat 423.
I think it's 432, isn't it? Is it 423? So where's Ryan?
We are at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard across from Cal Expo, among other things. We're weighing women. Any other women want to get weighed just for fun? Huh? Anybody just for the fun of it?
Come on,
get
it's
weighed?
Great.
Get on a scale. I know women love to get weighed.
By the way, British alcoholic guy, I said I'd drink one beer, not two. I mean, I got the rest of the day in front of me. In our country, we work.
We've got the cash equivalent of a pair of tickets tomorrow's playoff game, and we know somebody who could get you the tickets for the cash equivalent. Do you get it?
Awesome.
The Maloofs will sue us if we say we have tickets. So we're giving it to the biggest Kings fan by weight female division. Our current leader, the beautiful blonde, is sitting over there at 423 pounds. We have somebody in the building. Congratulations. Yes, applaud her weight. Yes, a big hand for her girth. And we have somebody in the building who claims that she weighs more than that.
Jack, before we do the weighing, if I may, a special celebrity appearance. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Basil. Hey. A little, I'd love to hear a little good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Our favorite Iraqi.
Very warm reception, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Basil, do you have a prediction for the Kings-Lakers series?
I just want to know if the Kings are going to play Boston or New Jersey Nets, that's all.
There you go. Fantastic.
That's your prediction? Are we ready to weigh this person? I'm really excited about this. I want to know what the heck this woman weighs.
Regarding the Rick Adelman's comment, I don't think he meant, you know, he took it back actually later on, and he said that he thinks Kopi is a great player. He's very a big threat to the Sacramento Kings, and that he's a unique player among the league.
He's going to cut off his balls.
Yes, do you have that clip
right,
there,
step Michael? Aside there.
Yeah, we have to have people that will cut his balls off.
Yeah, that's just wrong.
That's harsh.
That's certainly a flagrant foul.
Okay, we have how many contestants? Just one or two or three?
All we need is the one, I think.
Somebody send him up.
Well.
Right over here. Come on up.
This is...
what is your name, my dear?
So,
you a big Kings fan?
Yeah.
Well, yes, yeah, like technically she is. Even if she only kind of follows the sport.
Who are you going to take to the game?
Probably my friend who's over there that got me up this early in the morning to be here while he acting like he don't want to be on TV.
So your friend woke you up and said, I think you're big enough to win the contest.
Yeah,
with friends like
much,
that,
yeah, thanks, right?
Who needs enemas?
Hey, where's that friend? Point him out.
Right over there in the Kings jersey. Michael, bring your butt over here.
Get Michael a shot in of the Michael. House. Get all up in Michael over there.
There's Michael right there.
There you go. Nice yes, job, right, Michael. Bro. There you go. Michael wants to go to the game, so he wakes her up and says, you're big. Come on, let's go weigh you.
All right, Michael. He's excited about that game. What are you doing? You going to buy the dogs or, you know, the beers or something?
I'm be there.
All right, bring something to the party, would you?
Come on, get her on the scale.
Step right up. Once again, 423 is the standard we have to meet.
I'm excited about this. I can't wait till you announce this weight.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion. Congratulations.
What does this young lady weigh?
An impressive major league weight of 463 pounds.
Whoa! Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! People chanting 463.
All right, congratulations.
463?
And hey.
Look into a salad.
It's only 9/11. There is still time to come on down.
I kid. Of course I kid. Yeah, there's still time. If you're like that guy there and you know you got a friend or neighbor or mom or sister or whatever who is enormous, wake them up and tell them to come on down if you think they're heavier than 463.
Wow.
I got to tell you, that's a bit, for a woman, that's pretty big.
Yeah. What? How tall is she? About 5'5 or so?
That's 230-pound women. Look at it that
how
way.
How tall are you? Yeah.
5'2", 463.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, that might be hard to beat. But if you know anybody in that size range, get them down to bleachers on Exposition Boulevard at pronto.
Any prediction for the Kings-Lakers?
Oh, we're going to break them off.
Break the Lakers off. Any prediction, Kings-Lakers, Smoking Jackie? Do you have a prediction?
No.
No.
She's busy smoking and drinking. It's like a health club in here.
Oh, God.
All right.
And listen, we've got a full box of donuts from Donut City. Don't be shy, everybody. Enjoy some donuts between the smoking and drinking.
Really? For real?
What?
Tito's ex-girlfriend is here?
How much does she weigh?
No, it's not that.
Oh.
It's just for the entertainment value of talking about Hito. She doesn't weigh a lot.
Oh.
Hito's ex-girlfriend is here. Maybe we can question
her
about it.
Is she willing to chat, Scotty boy?
Yeah, okay. We'll talk to her after the break. We've got some more lookalikes. I saw a guy looked exactly like Hito was in here.
Yeah, wait. Where's the Hito lookalike guy?
Yeah, we'll have to talk to him. We're taking a break,
yeah,
Michael.
Hang on. Yeah. Yeah, we're taking a break. Yeah.
I will talk to him in just a few minutes. And, Michael, is everything all right back at the station, or have you dropped dead? If you're dead, wrap the microphone twice. Okay, there we go. We got the eating contest. We got more lookalikes coming up. Maybe we have somebody that weighs more than 463. I doubt it.
Yeah, there's always hope, Jack. There's
I don't think beyond hope. That you can come in under your own power.
No, that is absolutely incorrect. That lady, very petite at 5'2".
Somebody's going to come wheeling in on a rascal at the last moment and win this thing.
And won't that be exciting?
Yes, it will. All right, more to come. We're at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard across from Cal Expo. Stop by and see us. You're listening to the Armstrong and Getty Show.
And now back to Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
Hi there. Welcome back. We are Armstrong and Getty. Oh, yeah, I'll sign that. We're Armstrong and Getty. We're at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard. We'd like to have you stop on by and just hang out. We're kind of just reveling in the fact that we're all Kings fans, and we're looking forward to the big playoff game tomorrow. We got some fun contests going on. Biggest Kings fan by weight, female division. It's going to be tough to beat our current reigning heaviest woman at 463.
Wow.
Which, wow. That's a lot of woman. Okay. That is a lot of woman. We have got a couple of people in the building that look enough like Hito Turkoglu that I thought Hito Turkoglu had walked in here. It's odd. Is that all that we've had in terms of lookalikes?
We've got a couple of Hitos and a very questionable Vlade. We're still looking for Kings lookalikes. We've got a hat and a T-shirt for him.
If you're going to look like a King, you'd like to look like Chris Webber. Maybe you'd like to look like Scott Pollard. You end up looking like Hito. But what are you going to do?
All right, where's our new Hito look like? Come on over here, buddy. Come on, Hito. What's your name, bud?
Micah.
How often do people say, hey, you look like Hito?
Well, I work at a middle school, and all my middle school kids, they call me Hito when I walk on campus.
Who thinks he looks like Hito? He looks exactly like Hito. He even got kind of his teeth.
Huh?
You've got his teeth, even.
Come on, bro.
Well, I'm seriously. You look like Hito. I mean, you got the whole look. It's not an insult. You can't come down here to look like to enter a Hito lookalike contest, and I say you look like Hito and get offended.
All right, hang on. Where's the other Hito lookalike guy? All right. No, stand right here. That's cool. Where's the other Hito lookalike guy? Hey, other Hito. You were just here. Where is he? Okay, all right. We're going to have this young lady next to the Hito lookalike for a brief interview. Hi, what's your name?
Hi, Julie.
Julie, I understand you were Hito's ex-girlfriend. Is that correct?
Yeah, apparently so. Yes, I was.
What do you mean, apparently so?
Yes.
Okay.
Excellent mocking of my partner. I appreciate that. So you two dated for a little while? How long?
I don't know. It was a little while. We were just friends for a while, and then we kind of started our courtship. But
how long ago was this?
This was pre-nose job.
Pre-nose job?
Oh, my God. He got a new nose and traded up?
Wow, he got a new nose and dumped you.
What's that?
Did he dump you or you dump him? You dumped him?
Can I say that? He is so going to kill me for this.
Why? You didn't like the nose or what?
Well, he doesn't speak English.
Well,
you had a communication problem.
Well, we would get in arguments, and we couldn't I do not understand that word. Okay.
We just didn't communicate. He speaks Turkish. I speak English.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that. Any chance you two?
He's a great guy.
I believe that.
He's very nice. He's young. He's nice. Yeah.
Well, you're young. You're nice.
Got a lot going for him. His game was on last time.
How about did he spend lavishly on you?
I wouldn't let him. That's not why I was doing it. So
it doesn't have to be your primary purpose. You can still let him spend lavishly, right?
Yeah, well, but he lived with his aunt and uncle and just moved out on his own. But so I didn't let him. I didn't like it. I mean, I run around his car, and that's about all I did. I didn't let him. I actually spent money. I didn't let him.
All right.
How old are you? How old is he?
I'm 23. I think he's 24. He just turned.
But you said he's young, and he's actually older than you. So you're saying he's immature and
no.
Wouldn't.
We're talking with Hito's ex-girlfriend, but she dated him pre-nose job.
Oh God, this is terrible.
Well, you volunteered this.
Hotter now or with the big beak?
I didn't mind it. It didn't bother me.
It didn't bother
you
anybody.
He said, I think deviated septum was the problem.
Okay, here's a good question.
Say.
Do you think he actually had a deviated? I mean, he just got a nose job, right?
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
Which is fine. I have no problem with that.
Yeah. It looks good. And that, everybody gave him a hard time about it.
We didn't give him a hard time. He looked better.
My family did. No, okay.
About the nose job?
Yeah, I thought
so. The family's met and everything.
No. No.
Oh, to you.
I have an identical twin. He's met her, and that's,
Oh, really?
You have an identical twin, so he's kind of dated the twins?
No. But he's met her.
Okay.
Wild three-way was with number five, eh? That's fascinating.
No, you seem very, very nice, and it was nice of you to talk to us about your experience with dating Hito Pre-Nose Job. Yeah. I can't imagine any conversation you could have at all, because before this season, he couldn't talk at all.
It's hard. He taught me some, what do they call it, turkey language.
He taught
Turkish.
Gobble, 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 gobble.
Not a lot, evidently.
That's the turkey language. Gobble, gobble, gobble.
Go ahead, hit us with a Turkish phrase.
No, I just want you to know that, yeah.
Do you know any Turkish? Hit us.
A word. Do you know a single word in Turkish?
I don't know.
No wonder you can't communicate.
Do you guys know why we call him Hidu?
How come?
Well, his full name is Hiditu Turkulu.
Okay.
And so nobody can pronounce it, so they start calling him Hidu.
I don't know the Turkey language.
I'm going to get reamed for this. He's going to, this is bad.
That's none of our business. Hey, thank you. Thank you so much. Now, listen, you're a classy young lady. You've been kind enough to talk to us. Did he ever spend 3 seconds or more in your lane?
In my what?
In your lane.
Did the relationship progress to intimacy?
Did he take it to the hoop? I wasn't... No? Yeah. No comment?
Well, yes? Let me do the judging, and I'll ask him to pull down the drawers. Oh, my God.
I don't know what that meant. It's nice to talk to you.
She was going
to
judge the look-alike based on a full view, I guess.
Oh, I see. Enough said. Thank you very much.
That was very nice.
You got a great sense of humor.
That was very nice.
Big hand for Hito's ex-girlfriend,
everybody.
Yeah,
hand for Hito's ex-girlfriend.
Come on, ring the cowbell for Hito's ex-gal-pal.
That was very nice and probably incredibly unwise to do that interview with us about their dating relationship.
We got a couple of lookalikes. Our King's Lookalike Contest is ongoing, going on until 10 o'clock.
Oh, my God.
Look like a king.
I can't believe she did that. I really can't believe she came forward and talked to us like that.
Our battle in Hito's. Hey, where's Hito's ex-girlfriend? Wait a second. Honest to God, I mean, she's back to the bar, eh? Nobody let Hito's ex-girlfriend leave, because if it comes down to these two guys, we obviously have to have her declare the winner.
Decide who looks the most like, you know.
May have to step into the back room, but that's the way it'll work. All right, guys, get out of the way for just a second, because we've got a couple more lookalikes. We've got a Mike Bibby lookalike, as I understand it, and a Chucky Brown lookalike, whoever that is.
Does Chucky Brown play for the Kings?
Yes, he does.
He plays...
Oh, all right. All right, pretty good. What's your name, sir?
I'm Mike.
Actually, Mike, you're a better Andre Agassi lookalike than...
I've been told that.
Or John Barry.
A little Rick Adelman without the mustache.
You know, that's weird. He does look like Rick Adelman without the beard. Did you consider having him grow a beard?
Well, working on it. We're working on it.
Throwing on the blazer and turtleneck. You're terrified of me, aren't you?
Poor little kid.
Don't be afraid. I'm very gentle.
Kids and bars don't always mix.
Can you say Go Kings again? Thumbs up. All right. Go Kings. All right. Our Mike Bibby lookalike. Big hand. All right.
He looks more like John Barry, but, you know, whatever.
Thank you. A beer for our contestant and the milk for the child.
Now we have a Chucky Brown lookalike. Who the hell that is?
Chucky Brown. He's right there.
Is he a black guy? White guy?
he's a black man, Jack.
I don't even know who he is.
All right. Come on down. Chucky Brown lookalike?
Well, he could be Chucky Brown. I don't know if anybody gives a damn.
Could be Chucky himself. Where is he, Scott?
He's camera shy.
He's camera shy.
Well, it's going to hurt the contest.
Yeah, somebody's got to stick it. All right, he's right there. Gent with the cane there.
I swear to God, I cannot believe Hito's ex-girlfriend did that interview. I mean, that's just stunning to me.
All right.
That was so inappropriate.
Oh, yeah, it was terrible.
I mean, it was so out of line.
I can't believe it.
She's very attractive, though.
Oh, yeah, lovely.
Of course, it doesn't hurt to be, you know, a pretty good-looking NBA star. I mean, you know, in terms of getting chicks.
Word is they get paid pretty well.
She's very good looking. You know, she doesn't know how to keep her mouth shut, probably, but because she, you know, she talked too much there.
Oh, yeah, way too much. I mean, it's highly inappropriate. I don't think we should air any of that.
Yeah, that was really inappropriate.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it,
okay,
though.
Eating contest right after the break, right? My mic's cutting out, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right.
I got to hammer this one more time. I don't think there's a chance in hell it's going to happen, but if we have anybody out there, any woman listening, or anybody listening who knows a woman that might weigh more than 463, that is our current standard for going to the game tomorrow, you and a friend with the tickets, all right? The current standard is 463. Anybody bigger than that, you better get in your car and lumber on down here.
Who's the biggest Kings fan by weight, female division? You have About 31 minutes.
Yeah,
to get
not,
down here.
I'm not real confident anybody's going to. I don't know if there's anybody who weighs more than that in the greater Sacramento area, let alone that's, you know, listening and going to come down here.
Couple of good seats, $500. Yeah.
What's everybody cheering for? Just for the fun of it?
Yeah, because I guess they think we're going to break.
No, we can.
Yeah, we can. Why not?
Yeah, we'll take a break. When we come back, we'll do our eating contest, a few more lookalikes, and hopefully we have enough behemoth that will come rolling through the door. I mean, that'd be very exciting.
Hope springs
with the current number at 463. It's going to get up to bring it. All right?
Maybe roll through McDonald's, eat a little bit on the way. That could be the pound or two that puts you over.
And if you haven't heard the clip, we ought to play the Adelman clip where he talks about detesticulating Kobe Bryant.
Highly inappropriate.
Yeah. You're listening to the Armstrong and Getty Show.
And now back to Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
Welcome back. We are at Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard across from Cal Expo. Any more women in the crowd who've slept with a king? Because that interview was very enjoyable. No? Oh, I really liked that. It's very entertaining. We still have time for a fairly big-boned woman to come down and steal those king's tickets. If you weigh more than 463, you got 25 minutes to get down here to...
Hey, John, if I may, you got to be a little bit disappointed.
I'm very disappointed.
We had half a grand's worth of King's tickets for you.
Yeah.
You came so close.
6 months ago, I would have whipped her butt, but damn, I lost weight.
You were heavier 6 months ago?
75 pounds.
So what was the total?
Like 505.
You were 505?
Yeah.
Oh.
I had surgery in July, so I'm going to lose the rest.
What kind of surgery again?
That stuff you talked about the other day.
What do you think? Ingrown toenail.
The gastric band or the...
Yeah, no, the bypass.
The bypass. Okay, well, good luck with that. You're a very attractive woman, so...
Yeah.
There you go.
I'm excited.
Yeah.
Oh, you know...
It's a shame she wasn't heavier.
I hate to see such a sweet gal come so close and yet go down in defeat. Our current standard, 463.
Here come the hot dogs for the eating contest, ladies and gentlemen. About ready to eat hot dogs. This is for a... Page's jersey, provided by Sports Fever. They've got three locations.
Stadium dog contest.
Just like being at a Kings game.
By the way, we've got a little less than a half hour still left for lookalikes and somebody who can beat 463 pounds, a woman who can beat it. What is your name, sir?
My name is Van, and today is my birthday.
All right, happy birthday, Van. Congratulations.
Van's going to get, for his birthday, he's going to get indigestion.
Get all I can eat here. For...
Very exciting.
Hey, Debbie, do we have garbage cans? Yeah, bring out the garbage cans. Yes.
Oftentimes, somebody throws up.
What is your name, my friend?
Anthony.
Anthony, how do you feel?
Hungry.
Let's see. You've got in front of you, what, about 20 hot dogs. You think you can...
That's a tease.
That's an appetizer for Tony. All right, what is your name, sir, in the Lakers hat?
Rick.
Lakers hat.
We're going to break the Lakers fan off!
No way, man. No way.
And excellent excellent response. It's hard to argue with that.
Lakers in four. This guy says Lakers in four.
Kings in four! Kings in four, baby!
Yes, people are drinking this morning at the bar at Bleachers. And last year's biggest Kings fan by weight is in the hot dog eating contest this year. Oh, that's right. You took second place.
Yeah, Mark, how are you? You ready to eat some dogs?
Yeah, I'm ready to eat some dogs.
How did it feel last year when about 1 minute to 10, a behemoth walked in that bested you by, what was it, about 25 pounds? How did that feel?
Well, I felt cheated. I felt, honestly, that this person has never even heard of Armstrong and Getty.
Right. Yeah, he wasn't a loyal fan.
Yeah, Mark, a big fan. We appreciate that. We love you for that. And the other guy was just a hireling. He was a ringer brought in to defeat Mark.
Well, we got to get to eating started now. Are we doing, is this a timed event, or is it whoever finishes this many hot dogs? Nobody can finish this many hot dogs.
5 minutes.
Okay. You think you could eat them all? How many people think they could eat all these hot dogs? They all think they could eat them all. So you want to just do a race? They all think they can eat them all.
All right, listen. Let's let the crowd decide. Ladies and gentlemen, do we make it? Who can eat the most in 5 minutes? Or who can finish them first?
5 minutes or who finishes them first?
All right, all right. Well, wait a second. All right. First, who wants 5 minutes? Who wants to see him finish 20 hot dogs?
No.
The people have spoken.
You know, that's fine and all, but I don't think that people can eat 20 hot dogs.
I doubt it myself. You know, we've only got...
Well, we got to get started.
37 minutes, all right.
Okay, whoever finishes all their hot dogs first, we're counting them right now to make sure everybody's got the same number.
I thought we had five contestants.
Well, we'll be fine.
Wait a second. Who was stout? Do we have 20 more hot dogs? We've got a slot open. Hey, non-smoking guy won the smoking contest. You want to eat 20 hot dogs? Is there anything you won't do, sir?
Hanky's kind of like Ito's girlfriend.
No, you're not in? Do you want to come in? All right, good Lord, he's out of his mind.
Has everybody got 20? We got to get this going. This is going to be stunning.
All right. All right, hang on a second. We got to get another pan of hot dogs out here,
right? We didn't have any Ralphing in the smoking contest. We nearly did. I almost guarantee vomiting in the hot dog contest.
That's why the folks are here, Jack.
Do you think anybody can eat 20 hot dogs? I don't think so either.
You know, the dogs are making me really hungry. The smell of the dogs are making me starving hungry.
Okay, here's the pan of hot dogs.
The final pan. Jack, Scotty, put it in front of smoking guy.
Have they been counted? All right, let's get ready to rumble.
All right, because I'm bad at names. All right, just go ahead. Let's start it.
Gentlemen, start your bile. Don't eat yet. Don't eat yet. Get them all counted here, and then we're going to start. Are you ready? On your mark. Get set. Eat. First person to finish 20 hot dogs wins.
Stadium dog contest. Oh, he's dipping them in water. Smoking guy is dipping them in water. Oh, my God, and mustard water. I'll give a buck to anybody who'll drink that mustard water.
If you're just joining us, we've got a guy in the hot dog eating contest who smoked an entire pack of cigarettes and won that contest, and he doesn't even smoke.
Took him 8 minutes and 20 seconds. All right, smoking guys, off to a good start. There is no freaking way these guys are going to eat all 20 hot dogs.
No, you can't eat 20 hot dogs.
All right, we got smoking guy, big guy, Lakers, wife beater.
Call this Quaker guy.
And the Quaker, the fighting Quaker.
Okay, you're a Mormon.
All right, the fighting Mormon. We'll take that. All right, Brigham Young is looking pretty good there at the end. He's sipping his water. Smoking guys, dipping them in water. Hey, listen, we need an employee or one of our employees to keep bringing fresh water if they need it. Does anybody want any mustard, any ketchup, anything like that? All right, you're eating dog, then bun. Dog, then bun, dog, then bun.
That's He's eating his hot dog and bun separately. That's an interesting strategy. Now, there is going to be vomiting at some point. Do we have receptacles for that?
We do. Hey, listen, I'm not doing the puke bucket duty. Where's Scott? Somebody, Ryan, you're doing puke buckets, man. I'm not. I get paid okay, but I don't get paid that much.
Now, if they do blow chunks, can they consume that and then keep eating the hot dogs and you're still in the contest?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Well, I'm just asking. I want to know the rules. I don't want any technicality breakdowns.
I can't. All right, yes, Jack. They can re-ingest their own vomit and continue. Thank you for asking.
I just want to know the rules.
Jeez Louise.
I think it's important that you know the rules.
What do you think of the King's chances, sir?
Good.
Fabulous.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Mark, any chance the Kings will break the Lakers off?
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic. How you feeling? Fine. Would you like fries with that?
Sure, later. Yeah.
Fantastic. All right, now listen. Once again, got smoking guy, big guy,
right.
Laker, wife beater T-shirt.
And Mormon.
The Mormon.
Brigham Young down on the end.
The fighting Mormon. If you want to chant, if you want to cheer for your man, feel free. Come on in. You're the sixth man.
A lot of people cheering for smoking guy.
Has a consensus emerged? All right, listen. Who do you think is going to win? Who do you cheer for?
Smoking
guy. Big Mark. Oh.
Biggest guy gets a few applause.
Laker guy.
Boo.
Break the Lakers off.
Wife beater. Not literally, of course, just the T-shirt, sir. And the fighting Mormon.
Oh, God. You know why? People like smoking guy because... He's established himself as is like out there.
He has no limits.
By smoking that entire pack of cigarettes in 8 minutes.
We already beat the Jets.
And now he's eating. If you smoke a whole pack of cigarettes and then eat 20 hot dogs, you'll die, right? Won't you be dead by noon?
All right, hang on. Don't worry. I won't pull on the cord. Let me step over this. Hey, smoking guy, just out of curiosity, and I'm curious if you have any limits at all. If we had a what's the biggest object you can put up you contest, would you be in?
How about a glass-eating contest? Do you have anything you would say no to?
No glass eating, no object insertion. Well, that's good. It's good to know he has limits.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, I'm not going to make the same mistake I made with the smoking and go to break when people are eating their hot dogs, but there's no way they're going to finish anytime soon.
We could go to break right now. What's that kid yelling about back there? It's a zoo. It's good to see families bringing out their kids, though, Jack.
I'm a big fan of
early
kids in
morning
the bar.
Drinking and, exactly. and smoking contests.
It's a wholesome atmosphere.
Hey, or we could take a break right now. Break really early.
Yeah, let's do that. So we make sure we get this time we're going to get the end of the contest, all right? So we'll take a break, Michael. We got the yak buckets out because some people are starting to feel a little ugly.
Smoking guy just got 9 left. All right, take us out.
We got the rest coming up. Stay right here. We're at Bleachers, the Armstrong and Getty Show.
Armstrong and Getty for cool pools and hot tubs.
When it's summer in Sacramento, you've just got to have a pool. My whole family loves this pool we got from Cool Pools and Hot Tubs. These pools are incredibly durable. They set up in just a couple of hours, and they're really affordable. In fact, my wife and I like our pool so much, we got a jacuzzi from Cool Pools and Hot Tubs.
Hey, life's stressful. Get a jacuzzi.
Pools from $40 a month, jacuzzis from $60. Cool Pools and Hot Tubs, 3438 Watt Avenue, just south of I-80. Online at coolpools.com.
And now, back to Armstrong and Getty on KQCA 58.
Eat steak, eat steak, eat a big old steer. Eat steak, eat steak, do we have one beer?
Welcome back to Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard across from Cal Expo. We're right in the midst of our hot dog eating contest. Still time to come down here if you're a giant woman. The current weight to beat is 463.
We've got one contestant in the high house that we're going to weigh up soon.
Does she look like she's got a shot at 463?
A shot.
All right.
A shot, and it's worth taking that shot. Jack, funny, during the break, somebody was moving a keg in the next room, and I thought it was a contestant. I got all excited.
All right, we're in the hot dog eating contest. It's the first guy to eat 20 hot dogs. 20!
Non-smoking guy who won the smoking contest is down to about 8. Big Mark, about 7. Laker guy. Hey, Laker guy sucks.
Break the Lakers off!
He's got like 11 hot dogs left. Wife beater t-shirt is down to his final 5.5, but ladies and gentlemen, the fighting Mormon at the end, down to his last 5.
And it's his birthday.
Happy birthday to you, sir.
Everybody likes to have 20 hot dogs on their birthday.
Does anybody need the puke bucket? Close by.
Now, jeez, it's getting rowdy. Smoking guy took his sweater off. He's down to just his t-shirt now. He's got a bit of a Marlon Brando look going, and he's...
Yeah, you have, 12, 15 hot dogs. It makes you sweat a little bit.
Are you drinking beer? So you smoked an entire pack of cigarettes in 8 minutes. You're trying to eat 20 hot dogs, and you're drinking beer.
All right, way to go. All right, Jack, let's take a quick break from the eating contest to meet our next contestant. Hi, what's your name?
Kathy Hale.
We've got to weigh a woman.
Who are you going to go with? Who are you going to go with if you win these tickets?
Probably my brother-in-law, James.
All right, James, it all comes down to this. Go ahead, step right up, my darling.
The number to beat is 463.
436.
438.
Oh, it was a good try. It was a good try. Hey, a big hand anyway. A big hand.
Yeah, thanks for coming down. We appreciate it. Don't get us wrong. People are really applauding. People are applauding, and there's nothing wrong with weighing 438 pounds.
We have a lookalike entrant.
But it's not prize-worthy, apparently.
Yeah, okay. Keep your eye on the fighting Mormon at the end there, because he's down to his last 4.
Our polygamist has got 4 hot dogs to go.
Who do you claim to look like, sir?
Well, I let you be the judge of that. Everybody at work says Mike Bibby, so I figured I'd come up and get a second opinion.
And actually, your boys look, they've obviously got a little of their mom, but 3 for the price of 1 lookalikes. Hey, go ahead, buddy. You got something to say? Go Kings? All right, just big nod.
Well, let's get his picture up on the board. He do look like Mike Bigby, so you might be a winner.
All right, and we have to do the voting before we leave. You've got about 9 minutes to get down. If you are close to Cal Expo, close to Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard, which, by the way, the best place you can possibly go to watch a Kings game if you're not in the stadium, come on down to Bleachers. If you look like a King, come on by.
Okay, we got... you've got about, what, four hot dogs to go? Mormon guy has got 3.5 hot dogs to go. We are getting toward the end here with Brigham Young down here. 3.5 hot dogs to go. What is that, an anti-Mormon boo? What is religion? We will not allow religious intolerance. No religious intolerance in the building.
Oh, my gosh, in a stunning development, wife beater T-shirt is down to his final two full dogs, half a bun, and, like,
he's got several bear hot dogs he's taken a bit out of, like if you got a five-year-old. He just took a bite out of them.
Chew before you swallow.
All right, hey, Michael, and once again, let's hear the short clip of Rick Adelman demanding Kobe's balls on a silver platter.
Yeah, we have to have people that will cut his ass off.
Yeah, see, that is so inappropriate.
It's harsh.
God, I wonder if they're planning to do that like in the first quarter, like early in the game, or saving that for late in the game.
I think they want to set a tone, Jack.
That
I mean,
sets a tone.
Right off the opening tip-off, cut off the testicles of Kobe Bryant. All right, who likes Smoking Guy? Yeah! Smoking Guy. Who likes Big Mark? Big Mark. Oh, his support is a little iffy. Lakers guy. Wife beater T-shirt. And the fighting Mormon. Wow. Now, I don't know what crowd support means, but it's definitely focused on this end of the table. All right, guys, we got 6.5 minutes left.
Brigham Young is starting his third to last hot dog.
Reach deep inside of you, fellas. Where's the Chariots of Fire theme, Michael? We need a little inspiration here.
Think about that long Conestoga trip across the United States out to Utah. And how grueling it was.
They would have loved a couple of hot dogs. They would have thanked God for a couple of hot dogs.
Yes, they would have.
Got a young lady here. You're... Am I correct?
We skipped school, and my mom called in work for sick.
Yeah, see that? I love that. Mom yanked him out of school to bring him down to a bar.
Well,
that's great.
She's coming down here, and we haven't called in school yet, but she called her boss and said she had the stomach flu. And...
I think that sets an example. Mom pretended to be sick and missed work, and she pulled the kids out of school. That's great. And to come to a bar, hey, there you go.
Are you all aware the proceedings are being aired? All right. Now, you looked really bored before. Is that just your teenage I'm bored look that you have? Just kind of...
Love the Kings. I love you guys. I'll listen to you every morning.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That's just her default facial expression as a teenager.
My parents wouldn't let me skip school, and I was never exposed to things like people smoking packs of cigarettes or eating contests or drunkenness early in the morning.
All right. Do we have any more lookalikes? We're getting down to it here. Any more lookalikes? Anybody else? Any ladies who want to get weighed?
Anybody want to get weighed? No? Well, you don't count, sir. He's a Jeff Tweedy lookalike from Wilco.
Yeah, no kidding.
We're down to 2.5 hot dogs.
And Richard Branson, too, from Virgin Atlantic Airways and everything.
Exactly.
All right. We're getting down to it. Brigham Young down to his 2.5 hot dog. Listen, we may have to... We may have to call this good at 4:30. Now, once again, is somebody moving kegs, or is that another contestant coming in?
I don't. I got to tell you, I'm a little disappointed that nobody's thrown up yet today.
Uh-oh, Smoking Guy. He's got a bloody nose.
How do you eat so much you get a bloody nose? I didn't know you could eat so much you get a bloody nose.
I'm not a physician, but how the hell does that? Oh, my God. Wait a second. Ladies and gentlemen, Vlade Divac just walked through the door. Is that guy? Hey, guy in the gray sweatshirt, look right at us. Doesn't he look like Vlade?
Yes, he does.
Oh, my gosh. All right, listen. All right, two more. The Fighting Mormon has two more dogs left. We may have to decide our lookalike contest right now.
Hey, let's not get too distracted that we forget we've got a guy who's eaten so much he got a nose. Who knew you could even get a nosebleed from eating too much?
I'm not a physician, but I can't even imagine the process that takes place that gives you a nosebleed from eating.
Well, you smoked a pack of cigarettes in 8 minutes, and then you just ate 15 hot dogs. I would go straight to the emergency room. 16 hot dogs.
If
the guy's got blood running out his nostrils. That's not normal.
If this guy dies, I am going to feel guilty for like 10, 15 minutes. Yeah, he signed a waiver. Screw you. All right. Listen. All right, we got to do our judging for the lookalike contest.
Make it quick. A hot dog and a half
all right,
to go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the crowd is going to vote. Scotty, do we have our main contenders here? Really? Okay, we've got a truly impressive late entrant. You look more like Vlade to me than Bibby. No? Bibby? All right. All right, he calls himself a Bibby. Ladies and gentlemen, by your applause, let's start with Bibby Guy, Mike Bibby Guy. Okay. All right. In the middle, Hedo Guy number one.
Hey!
All right, silver medalist at best. And on the right, Hedo Guy number two. Do we, all right, let's narrow it down because it was pretty close. All right, just the Hedo guy. I'm sorry, Bibby guy and Hedo number two.
Right.
All right.
That's
who
all.
Likes Bibby guy? All right. Look, all right, cut it out. Look at Hedo guy number two looking down his nose like he knows. Hedo guy number two. Who won?
Bibby guy won. All right, Bibby guy's the winner. Congratulations.
Bibby guy.
You don't look like... Okay, before we wrap this up, I want to make sure I thanks... We've got to thank Sports Fever, who provided a lot of the prizes. Sports Fever, they got three locations. Get your Kings gear there. They got practically everything.
They're also in the big malls.
Yes, and Donut City providing donuts. Also, you know, I guess we got tickets for the Kings. We paid for them ourselves. So.
Yeah, thank you, us.
We're down to a hot dog and a half with Brigham Young down here.
Valley
Come on, man. Stuff it. Let's finish it before 10 o'clock. Come
Valley
on.
Valley Scale. We got to thank Valley Scale for our super scale.
Thanks, of course, to Bleachers on Exposition Boulevard for allowing us to be here. And everybody that came out, we appreciate
Bleachers.
You coming out. It was very nice of you.
Thank you very much, Bleachers. Best place to watch any game.
Sure, all it's right. Just like being at the game coming to Bleachers, as
all
far
right.
as I'm concerned.
Listen, let's call it at 59:30.
He can do it. I swear to God he can do it. I like the even round number.
Uh-oh,
20.
Look out. Look out. Lakers, guys. Hurl. 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 Hurl.
Jesus.
Oh, God, this is high class.
We need security to get out of here.
Yeah.
Got a guy bleeding because he ate too much. Another guy shaking and throwing up.
All right, listen. We're going to call it in 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8,
well, there's nothing
7,
to it.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Your winner!
Mormon guy.
Mormon guy by a dog and a half. So many people to thank, so little time.
Go Kings tomorrow. See
Kings
you Monday morning.
Kings got to break the Lakers. Oh, go Kings!
Okay, folks, show's over. Nothing to see here.
I love you, and good night.
Worst episode ever.
Yeah, we have to have people that will cut us off.
Break the Lakers off!
The Simpsons, tonight at 5 and 6 on KQCA 58.